Where exactly are we in the universe? Have you ever wondered where we truly are in the universe? Not just on Earth, not just in our solar system, but in the grand tapestry of existence. Let's take a moment to zoom out and explore this cosmic question together, starting small, Earth. First, let's start small, Earth. Earth is our home, a rocky planet orbiting a relatively average star, the Sun. But even this small beginning holds mysteries. Did you know Earth is 4.5 billion years old and that it's traveling through space at 67,000 miles per hour? That's fast enough to circle the globe twice in just a minute. Earth is also unique in the solar system. It has liquid water, a breathable atmosphere, and life. These characteristics make it an oasis in the vast desert of space. Our planet's position in the solar system, not too close and not too far from the Sun, is part of what makes this possible. Astronomers call it the Goldilocks zone. Expanding to the solar system. Now, let's move out a bit further. Our planet is part of a family of 8 planets. We call this family the solar system. At the center of this system is the Sun, a star that provides us with light and warmth. It's so large that it accounts for 99.86% of the solar system's total mass. The solar system is more than just planets. It includes moons, asteroids, comets, and even a vast bubble called the heliosphere. This bubble is created by the Sun's solar wind and marks the edge of its influence. Beyond the heliosphere lies interstellar space, where the solar wind meets the winds of other stars, the Milky Way, our galactic home. The Sun is just one of hundreds of billions of stars in the Milky Way galaxy. That's right, our solar system is a tiny part of a massive, swirling collection of stars, gas, and dust. In fact, the Milky Way stretches 100,000 light years across. That means light, traveling at 186,000 miles per second, would take 100,000 years to cross it. The Milky Way is a barred spiral galaxy. It has a central bulge, spiral arms, and a halo of stars and dark matter. Our solar system is located in one of these spiral arms, about 27,000 light years from the galactic center. This area is known as the Orion Arm, a relatively quiet region compared to the galaxy's bustling core, our galactic neighborhood. Now let's zoom out further. The Milky Way is part of a local neighborhood of galaxies. We call this the local group. It's a collection of over 50 galaxies, including our closest neighbor, Andromeda. Andromeda is about 2.5 million light years away and is on a collision course with us. But don't worry, it's not happening for another 4 billion years. The local group also includes smaller galaxies like the Magellanic Clouds. These dwarf galaxies are gravitationally bound to the Milky Way and orbit around it. Their interactions with us could provide clues about the formation of galaxies, superclusters, clusters of galaxies. The local group is part of an even larger structure called the Virgo Supercluster. This supercluster contains thousands of galaxies spread over 110 million light years. Yet even this vast structure is just a small part of something bigger. Superclusters are not isolated. They form part of a cosmic web of filaments and voids. These filaments are made of dark matter and galaxies, stretching across the universe like a vast network. The voids, on the other hand, are almost empty, with very few galaxies. The immensity of Laniakea. Enter the Laniakea supercluster. Laniakea spans 520 million light years and contains about 100,000 galaxies. Its name means immense heaven in Hawaiian, and it's fitting. This is where our Milky Way resides, along with countless other galaxies. Laniakea's boundaries are defined by gravity. Galaxies within it are drawn toward a focal point called the Great Attractor. This mysterious region exerts a gravitational pull, but its exact nature remains unknown. The observable universe. But the journey doesn't end here. Laniakea is just one of many superclusters in the observable universe. The observable universe itself is 93 billion light years across. It contains an estimated 2 trillion galaxies. Each of these galaxies holds millions, or even billions, of stars. The observable universe is limited by the speed of light. We can only see as far as light has had time to travel since the universe began, about 13.8 billion years ago. Beyond this horizon, there could be much more that we cannot yet perceive. What lies beyond? And yet, this is only what we can observe. There's more beyond, hidden by the limits of light and time. The universe might be infinite, stretching endlessly in all directions. Or it could be finite, curved like the surface of a sphere. Scientists are still trying to answer this question. Some theories even suggest the existence of a multiverse. This means our universe could be just one of many, each with its own set of physical laws and conditions. If true, the multiverse could redefine our understanding of existence. Where are we, really? So, where exactly are we? We are on a planet, in a solar system, in a galaxy, in a supercluster, in a universe. But here's the amazing part. No matter how small we seem, we're part of it all. Every atom in your body was forged in the heart of a star. You are literally made of stardust. This connection extends beyond Earth. The molecules in your body have traveled through space, been part of other planets, and even existed in ancient stars. You are a living part of the universe's history, reflecting on our place. Now let's bring it back to Earth for a moment. Knowing all this, doesn't it make you wonder, how did we get here? Why does the universe exist at all? And what's our place in this cosmic story? These are big questions, and they're not easy to answer, but that's the beauty of it. The more we learn, the more there is to discover. The universe is vast, mysterious, and awe-inspiring. And yet, here we are, curious and questioning. So, as we look up at the stars tonight, remember this. You are here, in this moment, in this universe. And that is extraordinary. Every time you gaze at the night sky, you are looking at a map of our place in the cosmos. And that simple act connects you to something far greater than yourself.